such visually oriented species that photography was a very natural way to do that. And so to be able to, you know, to take these pictures of just this amazing perspective that we have on our planet and the cosmos was really incredible.
We are joined by the astronauts of Crew 4. Thank you all so much for being with us today.
My pleasure. Thank you.
We know that photography is important. Tell us about training to be an astronaut photographer.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we've got an amazing training program across the board, but we do get specific training on how to use the cameras and how to take pictures both inside the space station of the science that we're doing and also pictures on the outside. And so really, from the day that we start our assigned crew training through the time that we fly, we meet with our photo instructors, photo TV instructors, on a fairly regular basis to go over the wide array of equipment, because we're not only dealing with our handheld cameras, but we have video cameras and an assortment of other cameras that we use both for inside and exterior filming. It's amazing to get one-on-one instruction like that on how to take pictures. We spend a little bit of time trying to take pictures around our simulator outside to develop those techniques. But what I shared with these guys as we were preparing is that you don't know how to take the pictures you're gonna need to take. And it's really trial by fire. You get up there and then you just start taking pictures. And so I don't know how long into it that you start to feel comfortable, maybe a month,
month or so, yeah.
That you really start to, you know, the settings for a particular type of shot, whether it's aurora or taking a picture of a city at night, you start to learn what works for you. And so it's really just trial and error to get to the point that by the end of the mission, we're able to produce some of the stunning photos that we're able to take.
There are a few different locations on board the International Space Station that we're able to take photographs of the Earth. One of our favorites is the cupola. So it has seven windows to the world, windows to the world, really, where you can watch the Earth go by, and really provides more of a wide view of the Earth. And so that enables us to capture a little bit more and have a bit more context for what we're taking photos of. And then we also have the wharf, the window observation research facility, which is in our lab module. And there we're able to similarly go in and take excellent pictures of the Earth in kind of a more higher resolution type of way. And so it's really neat to have those opportunities to take pictures for several different reasons, one of which is for scientific observation. So we are able to take photos of the Earth and look for surface processes and how they're changing over time. We can look for natural hazards that are occurring during our mission, so hurricanes, fires, volcanic eruptions, things like that, and really just be able to see Earth from kind of a planetary perspective, which is really neat.
You know, being in space, we get to do some incredible things, but to me, it was really, really important to be able to share that experience. And we're, you know, we're such visually oriented species that photography was a very natural way to do that. And so to be able to, you know, to take these pictures of just this amazing perspective that we have on our planet and the cosmos was really incredible. You know, and we're really blessed up there to have such a wide array of cameras and lenses and clearly a great spot, location, right? To take these pictures. And so that was really, really important to me and a real payoff, you know, to really be able to, for us to take these pictures and then share with, you know, with everybody what that experience and what that perspective that we have up there.
Awesome. Well, thanks for talking with us about photography. Let's check out some of the amazing pictures from this expedition. Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.